Shalom. Praise to the Most High Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashem, Rekai, Kodash. Double honor to the apostles, the elders, great millstone, who rule well. Peace and salutation to you, brothers, overlook, pushing this word of truth and sincerity. All right. Back with there's a quick hit here. And it just simply answering the question of, what was Solomon's sin? Okay. Why did the Lord rent or take the kingdom from him or tear it from him and divide it? Okay. How did he sin? You know, because it's been said that he went off by having multiple wives when that was not what the sin was. Okay. We just gonna get straight into it. Okay. So this is 1 Kings chapter 11 and verse 1. It says, but King Solomon loved many strange women. Okay. And when you go and get into the word strange, it basically means like alien, or basically those women of another nation. Okay. Outside of Israel. Okay. But King Solomon loved many strange women, together with the daughter of Pharaoh, women of the Moabites, Ammonites, Edomites, Zidonians, and Hittites, of the nations concerning which the Lord said unto the children of Israel, ye shall not go in to them, neither shall they come in unto you, for surely they will turn away your heart after their gods. Solomon clave unto these in love. Okay. So he was disobedient. Okay. He went after those women and brought those women in unto him. And they say he clave. He drew close to him in love. Okay. He really had a love for these heathen women. And it says, and he had 700 wives, princesses, and 300 concubines, and his wives turned away his heart. Okay, turned away his heart from who? From the Lord, from Yahweh Shemal Shai. Okay, and it says, for it came to pass when Solomon was old that his wives turned away his heart after other gods, and his heart was not perfect with the Lord his power, with Yahweh his power, as was the heart of David his father. Okay, now it says that the Lord instructed us not to, I'm gonna read verse 2 again. Of the nations concerning which the Lord said unto the children of Israel, ye shall not go into them, neither shall they come in unto you, for surely they will turn away your heart after their gods. Okay? And that's what the problem was. All right. Let me see, cause I'm gonna grab that law. Is Exodus 34? Yeah, this is it. Okay. So, let me get back. So what's it? So this is Exodus chapter 34 and verse 9. It says, and he said, if now I have found grace in thy sight, O Lord, let my Lord, I pray thee, go among us, for it is a stiff-necked people, and pardon our iniquity and our sin, and take us for thine inheritance. And he said, behold, I make a covenant before all thy people, I will do marvels, such as have not been done in all the earth, nor in any nation, and all the people among which thou art shall see the work of the Lord, for it is a terrible thing that I will do with thee. Observe thou that which I command thee this day. Behold, I drive out before thee the Amorite, and the Canaanite, and the Hittite, and the Perizzite, and the Hivite and the Jebusite. Okay, so the Lord took those people out of the land and set it up for us. And he had one request. Verse 12, it says, "Take heed to thyself, lest thou make a covenant with the inhabitants of the land whither thou goest, lest it be for a snare in the midst of thee." Okay, how will it be for a snare? Because if you make a covenant with these heathen, it'll be a snare unto you, because then you'll start worshiping their gods, and it'll be a trap, and then you'll start going off, okay? And then through you going off, you'll be punished. And that's what happened. And he says, "But ye shall destroy their altars, break their images, and cut down their groves. For thou shalt worship no other power or no other god, for Yahweh, whose name is Jealous, is a jealous power." Okay? "Lest thou make a covenant with the inhabitants of the land, and they go a whoring," focal point here, "and they go a whoring after their gods, and do sacrifice unto their gods, and one call thee, and thou eat of his sacrifice." You hear that? "And thou take of their daughters unto thy sons, and their daughters go a whoring after their gods, and make thy sons go a whoring after their gods." See, it was a whole reason for why the Lord didn't want us intermingling with those, those heathen, because he knew that we would in turn start worshiping their gods. And this is what happened with Solomon. Okay, so it says, I'm going to start at verse 3 again, 1 Kings 11 and 3. "And he had 700 wives and princesses and 300 concubines, and his wives turned away his heart." Okay, "for it came to pass when Solomon was old that his wives turned away his heart after other gods, and his heart was not perfect with the Lord his power, as was the heart of David his father. For Solomon went after Ashtoreth, the goddess of the Zidonians, and after Milcom, the abomination of the Ammonites. And Solomon did evil in the sight of the Lord, and went not fully after the Lord, as did David his father." Here you go. That was the sin of Solomon. Here you go. "And Solomon did evil in the sight of the Lord, and went not fully after the Lord, as did David his father. Then did Solomon build an high place in Chemosh, the abomination of Moab, in the hill that is before Jerusalem, and for Molech, the abomination of the children of Ammon. And likewise did he for all his strange wives, which burnt incense and sacrifice unto their gods." Okay? "And the Lord was angry with Solomon, because his heart was turned from the Lord, from Yahweh, the Lord power of Israel, which had appeared unto him twice, and commanded him concerning this thing, that he should not go after other gods, but he kept not that which the Lord commanded." Okay? And it says, "Wherefore the Lord said unto Solomon, for as much as this is done of thee, and thou hast not kept my covenant and my statutes, which I have commanded thee, I will surely rend the kingdom from thee, and will give it to thy servant." Okay? "Notwithstanding in thy days, I will not do it for David, thy father's sake, but I will rend it out of the hand of thy son." Okay? So, the kingdom wasn't torn or taken from Solomon's hand during his lifetime, but after he passed, when his sons Jeroboam and Rehoboam came, that's when the split, happened. Okay? But it was just a quick hit lesson on that, because, it wasn't that he had those many wives, 700 wives, 300 concubines. Okay, it wasn't that. It was the fact that he began to worship the idols or the gods of the heathen or the concubines. Okay, that was the Solomon's sin. Okay, all right, so call all y'all, Bashem, Shabbat, Shabbat, Kako, Dash, Shalom.